منها وعلى أرضها ظهر قبل 5500 سنة.
And on its land, 5,500 years ago, appeared everything that is crucial enough to be named history. The first appearance of a city had emerged, including writing, management, and education, all components of the legendary Mesopotamian civilization. The Mesopotamian civilizations are divided into many periods. The Sumer civilization lasted for 1,500 years. Behind me is ivory from the city of Ur in southern Iraq, a period ruled by the famous king Ur-Nammu. This is a sample of the artifacts which trace back to this era from several sites. For example, the Mask of Warqa, as the Germans call it, but the Iraqis call it Lady of Warqa. This vase is also from Sumer, called the Warqa vase, which was used in the temples. It was stolen from the Iraqi Museum, but then found and restored. It is considered the most important artifact in Iraq's National Museum. Lastly, we have the statue from the ancient Sumerian era, Statue of Ashona from Diyala. Now, we shall move on to the Akkadians, the Semite people who came from the Arabian Peninsula and settled in Iraq since the beginning of the 3rd millennium BC. Hence, the Akkadian-Sumerian modern civilization. Only 2 centuries later, the Sumerian presence disappeared from the history of Mesopotamia and the Near East. No one knows until today where they came from, but the biggest mystery is how they built this great civilization. As for the Akkadians and the Neo-Sumerian periods, their monuments have been divided. The Great Ziggurat of Ur is located in southern Iraq in Diqar province. It is one of the most important cities of the Sumerian civilization in Mesopotamia in the 3rd millennium BC. The ziggurat was made for the gods of moons, Inanna. Here we have the mask of the Akkadian king Sargon, also known as Sargon the Great or the Great King. He is one of the most prominent figures of this stage, Sargon or Sarukan, along with his grandson, Naram-Sin. And of course, we have all heard of this king. The Sumerian king rests a basket on his head during the construction of the temple, as a symbol of his work effort and his seek for blessings from the gods. In the south of Iraq, this king was known as a builder and patron of the city. French searched for him in the end of the 9th century and excavated 22 statues, 13 which are in the Louvre now. This king is known as Khudia, founder of the city Lakhsh.